Now, people in Leicestershire who have, well, I suppose you might call it a family mystery that could be solved using DNA, are needed to come forward again for a brand new series of DNA Family Secrets. The show's been commissioned for a third series. If you've watched it, you'll know that our local, brilliant, fabulous, amazing Professor Turi King from the University of Leicester is the woman behind the DNA analysis, I suppose, and you're in the studio. Hello.
Hello.
Look, we're really excited about this, and I know we feature the show on this show a lot, partly because we're friends, but actually, we, as I've said so many times in the past, it's a beautiful TV show.
I love it. I love that we can answer questions for people. And it's usually something that's quite a deep question about their identity, such as they don't know where their ancestors are from, or they were adopted, or they don't know who their biological father is. And yeah, I love that it's a really caring program.
You've done my DNA, and you know, we'd held that thing years ago about, you know, the Vikings. And as you said, most people have got Viking DNA in one way or another. You can do that, and that's a useful thing. This is much more niche, isn't it?
Mm.
This is about things that in many cases have bothered people, that have affected them to their core most of their lives.
Yeah. I mean, that's the thing. So it's people who they're adopted, or they find out their biological father isn't the person they thought it is, or their, you know, sperm donor kid. And it's very much about their identity, like who they are. I mean, that's a really deep question. And they've often had it for decades. And now, with the technology these days, you can use DNA to help them answer some of these questions. And I think that's a really powerful thing to be able to do.
It's testament to how the program's gone down as well, hasn't it? That you've been commissioned for a third series. It's a complex TV show to put together. So that's a real confidence boost, I would think, isn't it?
It is. And obviously, there's a massively wonderful team behind it who are doing all of this. So we have got, obviously, the production team. We have got counselors. We've got social workers. We've got genealogists, we've got all kinds of people who are behind the scenes all working on it to bring it together. So we're also really excited to be working together again, because that's the really nice thing about it. Stacey is pregnant, and so it's pushed filming back for a little bit, but I'm very much looking forward to being able to sort of bounce the baby if she needs to bring baby along. But it's just such a lovely team to work with as well. I think that kind of comes across.
Stacey Dooley, a lot of people will know from Strictly, but she's got this incredible track record in documentary making. And it strikes me, every time we watch it, my wife says it the same. She's got this incredible ability to talk to people about really hard stuff in this very gentle, open-faced, inquisitive, but not intruding.
Yeah.
It's got an amazing tone to it.
She's brilliant. Well, she's hugely empathetic because she grew up, her father, who she, you know, grew up with, was not her biological father. So to some extent, she has that life experience that she can bring to it. But she's also just one of these really genuinely warm people. And it's really sweet because people will go, oh, you work with Stacey. Is she as nice as she is on the telly? She really is as nice as she is on the telly. She's just this really lovely, warm person. Everyone kind of just warms to her and opens up to her because she gives them kind of a space to do that. And it's not judgmental. Mm. It's very open and caring. And I think that's kind of the theme of the whole program.
I mean, it's an interesting development for you in a way, isn't it? Because your whole career from a scientific perspective has been about DNA. It's about genealogy. It's about tracing that DNA through generation after generation after generation. What an incredible sort of place to be at in your career.
I love it. I mean, how lucky am I? I mean, it started off doing surnames and genetics. So I would get people who would contact me and say, I've got this particular surname, and there's someone over here, they've got this particular surname. Well, David Attenborough took part in one of my PhD projects, and they would want to know if they were connected or not. And quite often I would say, well, you know, the DNA connects you. Now it's finding the genealogical evidence. But that was at a kind of a longer sort of time frame. This is very close. Usually not knowing about, you know, if they're adopted, they don't know what their ancestry is. I don't know, where were my parents from? And so being able to kind of give them these answers, yeah, it's very deep, and it's about their identity. That's what it seems to boil down to.
It's very sort of a great deal of honesty on the show as well, isn't it? Because what you don't do is pick the stories that all have a happy ending or a dramatic ending or whatever it might be.
Yeah.
You pick the people, you do the story, and warts and all, no matter where that DNA search takes you is what we see on the television. And sometimes all people's questions aren't answered. you know, that's the reality of it.
Yeah, I think that's a really important thing about our series. So I know other television series, what they do is they'll take, you know, loads to begin with, and they'll follow them through. And the ones that are interesting are the ones they'll take forward. We work the other way around. So we pick our people right at the very beginning, and we follow them all the way through. And I think there's a couple of things there. So first of all, I just think how amazing our contributors are, because they allow us to go with them. None of us know where this is going to go. And I think that's why it's so important there's such a big support team behind the scenes, because it is really an emotional roller coaster. And I certainly feel that when I'm giving people results, you can feel who they are is kind of changing right in front of your eyes. And it's a massive responsibility. But I think the other thing is that's the reality of doing this DNA testing. And quite often what happens is, you know, we might not be able to give someone an answer there, but, you know, 6 months, relatively recently, so Tink from Series 1, she just found out she has a new half-sibling. Matthew, who was on Series 2, we think we might have found out who his biological father was. So the work doesn't finish when it stops. And sometimes we can answer questions, but there's still questions. So I literally just had a phone call from Richard from Series 1, who we were able to tell him sort of who his biological father was, but he now wants to know more about that family. What's his ancestry going back? Who is his grandfather? This kind of thing. So for some people, we're able to answer the questions, and for others, it opens more questions, really.
It also, frankly, if I may say so, opens up a series going back to see what had happened.
Yeah, absolutely.
Even my producer, look, he's nodding so much, his head's going to drop off. Because actually, you do want to know. One of the great joys is that we're able to keep in touch, for example, with Bill from Loughborough, who's, you know, raising money today, this evening, at the Three Nuns in Loughborough. I think it's 8 o'clock. He's holding a quiz to help raise money, because he's got some health issues, to pay the insurance, the medical insurance, just to get there.
Yeah.
And that's an ongoing story. I mean, his life has been changed
by this. I mean, so that's one of the nice things. So my husband and I have been doing a series of podcasts with people from Series 1, going back and going, so what happened next? Because it obviously doesn't end for people when the program ends. So Tink has now got a half sibling, and she's now going through all the questions about, do we meet? Do we not meet? And, you know, these are really quite difficult and emotional decisions and things that they're making. So, yeah, absolutely. I think there's scope for what happened next.
Do you get through as many tissues as the contributors
do? Absolutely. Oh, my goodness. I can't tell you how emotional it is. I get home from a day's filming and I am exhausted. Yeah. And it's because I can't explain it. It's like when somebody comes in, I go into a bit of a bubble with them. And it's just me and them. And we're just taking it slowly through the whole process. Obviously, people see the edited version, but it is quite a slow and gentle process, taking them through what we have found and stopping if they need to stop. I joke about those tissues are actually for me. I feel everything that's kind of coming off of them, and I feel like we're very much in it together. So yeah, hugely emotional. I always warn people, get tissues if you're going to watch it. Yeah, I love it. It's a great program.
It is a great program. So look, you're on the hunt for people again.
Yeah. So this is if anybody's got a family mystery. So if it's anything like you're adopted and you would like to see if you could find one of your parents, or I mean, we had some interesting ones on both series about people who were clearly of mixed ancestry, mixed race, and they would know one side, but they didn't know what the other side was. And so we could help them with that kind of thing. Some people have had it where they've taken DNA tests and they find out actually they don't match their siblings. Mm. They're the odd one out. And so we can take their DNA and we can help them find answers to some of the questions that they have.
If somebody's listening to this thinking, I've not had the courage so far, but I'm going to this time, how do they get in touch?
So they need to get a hold of Minnow Films, who are the production company. And what they do is they email dna@minnowfilms, and that's all one word, and minnow the fish, .co.uk. And there is a production team behind the scenes who are going through all of the emails that are coming in, and they read through them and they go, oh, okay, that sounds an interesting one. And then they get in touch with people, things like this.
dna@minnowfilms.co.uk. Mm-hmm. And look, just finally, again, what intrigues me is a major part of your role at the university is actually about public engagement, isn't it? About public engagement in science. Who'd have thunk it that DNA, which is quite, you know, it's a chewy old scientific subject, isn't it? That DNA would be so prominent, you know, first and foremost, that essentially teaching us how DNA works every week. It's incredible.
That's what I love about it. It's like with the Richard III thing, in that you get to slip the kind of the hard science into a story. And then hopefully people are learning a little bit more about how our DNA is inherited, what it can tell us, what it can't tell us. But yeah, no, I absolutely love it. Any way that I can talk about genetics and science and bring it to the public in a really accessible way, of course, it's perfect.
Turi, it's lovely to see you. Let's talk more about the series once you start to narrow things down. But again, just to reiterate, for heaven's sake, if you think Turi and the team can help, DNA@minnowfilms.co.uk.